Mangoes. Today we are in the second session of this chapter, that is chapter 7, Geography, chapter 3, Our Changing of the Earth. In the last video, I have discussed about the changing of the earth, how does the earth changes, some of the important changes I have, some of the important thing I have discussed, what are the important topic that we are going to discuss in this chapter. So, and some of the important points, some what I have discussed about the lithospheric plate, yes or no? So today we are going to learn what is lithospheric plate, how does this movement happen due to the lithospheric plate, okay? How does the earth move due to the lithospheric plate, okay? So actually we will learn what is lithospheric plate, okay? What is lithospheric plate? Actually, the whole lithospheric or land part of the earth's surface is broken into a number of plates or the slabs, okay? So, have you seen the slab, ice slab, you can see ice slab you have seen, yes or no? So, same as this, the whole landmass of the earth crust is broken into a number of plates. This block of landmasses are known as the lithospheric plate, okay? So, these landforms or this land part or the earth crust is known as the lithospheric plate. Broken down into a smaller pieces or smaller number of pieces, which is called the lithospheric plates. Okay, so this lithospheric or the earth crust, this lithospheric plates can be a several small rigid. It can be a small and rigid. It can be a irregular in shape, and it can be which can be carried by the ocean. Some plates may be having a smooth shape of the smooth shape. It can be a square shape. It can be an irregular shape. That means it doesn't have a proper shape. Okay, so that is why it is said that this is some are very small, some are huge, some are rigid, some are smooth in shape. Okay, so and this landmass, as in the last video I have discussed, this was the that is why it's called the lithospheric plate. So in the last video I have told you about the landmass, yes or no? Before the thousands of years ago, that means it was one earth in that one of the small landmass was present, which was called the Virginia. After some time it was being broken down into smaller pieces and it moves away apart from each other. Yes or no? In the last video I have told you. Yes or no? So these parts which is broken down, that is called the lithospheric plate. Okay, or the slabs. Okay, so these slabs, or we can say these slabs can be it is moved. Okay, so how it can be moved, or we can say you can see here what it is saying, that this plates move around very slowly. Okay, and these are, as we know, how it is, as I told you, these broken pieces move away from each other. How? Okay, because if the earth crust is moving, it is something that it is floating on something. Yes or no? That is why it moves. For example, take one bucket of water. In that, just you put one paper. Okay, you can see, sometimes you can see this paper move away to the side wall. Yes or no? Towards the side. Yes? So it happens. Okay. So same as this also, this plates also, this lithospheric plate also moves very slowly. We cannot feel it. It happens very slow. Very slow that we can't even feel it. Okay. So the movement is because of the molten magma inside the earth crust. And this is due to the molten magma. yes or no? The magma which comes out of the volcano, yes or no? So in the last chapter you have learned about the layers of the earth, yes or no? That is the crust, the mantle and the core, yes or no? You have learned that. Okay, so on the topmost layer is the earth crust or the crust. Below that, that is the mantle, that is the mantle in which the molten or the magma is present, in which the molten or the magma is present. Okay, so this is in the fluid form, or we can say liquid form. So it makes the this liquid form, this molten magma is in liquid form in the mantle. So this molten magma helps this lithosphere to move around. It helps the this molten or this plates to move around from one place to another, or we can say move towards each other. Okay, it happens due to that. Okay, so if you talk about, for example, okay, and movement, and this movement of molten magma, and this we can say, and this lithosphere or this molten magma, what we call, revolves in circular motion, means it moves in circular motion. For example, best example if I talk about, if you have seen the making of tea, if you have seen the making of tea, first of all, it is being, what we call, your mom may be, making the tea, you can see it, under there is a flame, is it not? She just put on the flame, and over there she put the beaker, and on that she put the water, yes or no? After that, sometimes you can see it start to boil. It start to boil, yes or no? So you can see when it becomes when the temperature of the boiling it becomes so much high, you can see the bubbles comes out, yes or no? Bubbles comes out like this. It comes in the form of a, it comes in this way, from the down and towards the like this. It comes like this. It comes like this. So same way, this molten magma boils up and comes up like this, in this way, in the circular manner, in the circular manner. So due to that, what happens? This lithospheric plate, or we can say this plate or the slab, start to move away. Just you bear it, just if you want to see the experiment of this, how it moves, how the lithospheric plate moves due to the molten magma. Okay, so when it is boiling, you just put one paper or one piece of paper over that inside the boiling water. Okay, you can see after some time this paper moves towards the side of the wall of the beaker, yes or no? It moves side, it automatically happens. So this is the way how the molten magma boils up and comes down in a circular way. Okay, so what happens? So this is how the lithospheric plates move. Okay, so if you talk about that, there can be a how does the lithospheric move? It moves in a three ways. Okay, one is, if you talk about, one is divergent. Lithospheric move in a divergent. Okay, one in a what we call convergent, and one in a transform. So this lithospheric moves in three ways. Okay, divergent, 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 convergent, 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 and the transform, that is transform. In these three ways it moves. Okay, so if you talk about this one, you can see divergence. Okay, so divergence means it's divergent. That means it moves away from each other. The plates move. For example, this is two plates. Okay, it is being joined together. So what happens due to the movement of the lithospheric plate? Somewhat it moves away like this. It moves away. So when it moves away, that is called the divergent. Okay. Another, if we talk about the convergent, that means convergent means if this is a two plate, it is very far away from each other, it will move towards it, each other. Okay. So from far it will come closer to each other. That is called the convergent. Divergent means to move away, and convergent means to come together. Okay. Another is the transform. nucleus is formed. That is why it is called the transverse. So these way of, these are the three ways of movement of lithospheric plate. Okay, so as I was discussing about the how the movement happened, that means it is due to the movement of the molten magma inside the earth crust. So if you talk about how does it boil, how does it it forms in a liquid form, because the core is so much hot. As I told you, core is present in the deepest. Yes, and this is very high temperature. Due to that, what happened? The pressure which is given by the earth crust and the heat which is given by the ground. So in the middle part, what happened? All the materials or all the minerals which is present in the between, what happened? It becomes so much compressed and it becomes started to melt little by little. Started to melt little by little. Okay, due to that, the metal contains is present in a molten form or in the liquid form. Okay, so this is how the earth crust moves. Okay, so it can move in two different ways. You can say the earth movements are divided on the basis of the force. Okay, so it can be it is divided in a basis of a forces, which are the two forces that we call is the one is endogenic forces and another is the exogenic forces. One is endogenic forces and other is the exogenic forces. So the movement can happen in two ways. One is endogenic forces and another is the exogenic forces. So if these are the two forces or these are the two ways how the movement happens on the earth crust. So in the next video, I'll tell you what is endogenic forces and what is exogenic forces and how does it happen. Okay, thank you for now.